It's actually not even a significant challenge, it's a sad one. And I'm going to explain to you slowly. Khalid mentioned the N2 gateway. 8 colored families got houses on the N2 gateway. Do you know how many units there are there? Hundreds. 8 colored families. It's a failure. We cannot, as the colored community, we can't applaud that. You know, when they built the houses in Johannes, Mankies at the back there, I was the only person in that hall who stood up and told Bongi Madikizela, you cannot tell us Mitchell's Plain can only receive 20% of the houses. Because they wanted to give it a 20. Then they came back with an offer of 50%, and I said no. But people, who I will not name, went and accepted the compromise. At the end of the day, Mitchell's Plain only received 50% of the houses. Now, here's my issue with all of this. If you start build, when they build houses in Langa, how many colored communities get houses? How many colored people get houses? None. Why is integration only happening in the colored areas? The answer to all of this is to let sanity prevail. Now, Malusi Boy, the former MAKO member for housing in the city of Cape Town, was arrested by the, was raided, I can't think like this, was raided and investigated by the Hawks. I predicted that 6 months before the time. You know who protected him? The DA. When we exposed 600 million rands worth of fraud and corruption within the south, in the housing department, the only party to ever have done it, you know who lied about it? The DMA in the city of Cape Town. Now, this is the same party that sends 1 billion rand of the housing budget back unspent, as if we don't have a housing problem. All these squatter camps all around Cape Town is allowed to flourish by the DA. They use SWAT gevaar against us. When colored people try to claim a little bit of land like here in Captain's Klip, we are met with brutality. If you want the answer to the housing issue, it's a very simple one. Let fairness prevail. There was a housing waiting list prior to 1994, which was 80% colored. Aunties, go to the housing department. Go and check if you're on that list. Your name has been scrapped, and that's why you're not receiving houses. And that is brought to you by the DA.
I want to quickly, before I get the DA to respond on this issue, I've heard from certain politicians that there is this thing called the construction mafia, that when they come into communities like this, they are being stopped by locals in producing those particular homes. I want to, since you are from this area, Fadil, I want to understand how serious of a problem or hindrance is the supposed gang construction mafia to the building of houses?
It's a massive problem, but I'm going to give you a quick backstory. You know why it happens? Check the Mannenberg School of Skills. A white-owned company gets awarded a tender above a colored female who's 6 million rand cheaper. People get frustrated because what they do is illegal. These people are turning us into criminals. People are dying to work. They are refusing us the opportunity to work and grow. Who's the construction mafia? Owen Ingalls gave us a gang boss security tender. They win more tenders. Who's the construction mafia? Tell us who the construction mafia is white owned. They only target us as people of color who are dying of hunger, man.
All right, let's go.